Convert 0.036 to a fraction? Why would I want to do that? I already know what the number is. It's 0.036. Ah, whatever. They asked me to do it. I'll go ahead and knock one of these off. How are we going to do this? Start with 0.036. I want to make it a fraction. Well, I can write this as an integer times a power of 10. And powers of 10, that's going to be easy to write as a fraction. So that should work. I'll write this as 36 times. See, I'm moving the decimal. I want to move the decimal three places to the left to make 0.036. So I need to multiply this by 10 to the minus 3. And check that again. 36 times 10 to the negative third, that means decimal point goes 1, 2, 3 places. Okay, we got it, 0.036. Of course, 10 to the minus third, that's just 1 over 10 cubed, which is 1 over 1,000. And 36 times 1 over 1,000, that's just 36 over 1,000. Now, of course, there's a common factor of 4 in both of these, so we're going to take that out. Take the 4 out of 36, we're left with 9. Take the factor of 4 out of 1,000, we're left with 250. All right, so this decimal here, 0.036, is 9 over 250. I don't know why we care about that. We'll go on to the next problem. Decimal multiplication, we know how to handle this. All right, we just take the decimal, we write it as an integer, times a power of 10, this is just 6 times 10 to the minus 1, and we'll take the 6 and multiply by the 525, and what? Oh, yeah, we could write this as a fraction too, but why do we care? I mean, all right, okay, I'll do it. We'll write this as a fraction, 10 to the minus 1, 10 to the minus 1, that's just 1 over 10. 6 times 1 over 10 is 6 over 10. Oh, yeah, I guess we could have just seen that, right? 6 tenths. Could have gone straight from here to here. All right, good enough. 6 tenths, we'll take out the common factor of 2, and that leaves us 3 fifths. And, well, why do we care? Oh, that's brilliant! When we have it as a fraction like this, if I turn this 0.6 into a 3 fifths, then my problem is just 3 fifths times 525. We have a common factor of 5 here. That makes this a lot easier. Divide 5 into that, we get 105. And my answer is just 3 times 105 is 315. Oh, that was really convenient. So we see sometimes we turn a decimal into a fraction. We can do some of these computations much more easily. Let's try one more. I've got a division here. Dividing by decimals, this is a bit of a pain. We know how to do that, but let's try that decimal to a fraction thing because dividing by fractions is easy. So I'm going to try to turn this 0.375, this 0.375 into a fraction. And we saw with the earlier two, we can start off by writing this as an integer times a power of 10. And once again, I'm going to check 375 times 10 to the minus third. Decimal 1, 2, 3 places to the left, sure enough, we got it. So this is 1 over 1,000, so this is going to be 375 over 1,000. You see this is 375 thousandths. So we could have probably gone straight from here to here. So how can we simplify that? Well, I see a factor of 125. 125 goes into 375 three times. And it goes into 108 times. And if you didn't see that right away, you could just prime factorize this. This one's obviously 2 cubed times 5 cubed. And the one on the top, you pull out that factor 3, and the 125 will jump out at you. That's 5 cubed as well. Knock that out, and we're left with 3 eighths. So now our problem is just 36 divided by 3 eighths. 36 divided by 3 eighths, and of course that is the same thing as 36 times the reciprocal of 3 eighths, which is 8 thirds, knock out the factor of 3 here. We're left with 12 times 8 is 96, and we're done.